Suppose that all non-diagonal entries of an n by n correlation matrix are equal to some value rho. What are the upper and lower bounds for possible values of rho? If you would like to try the problem yourself, pause the video here and come back to check your solution. Now, a correlation matrix has three properties it needs to satisfy. Its values must be between minus 1 and 1, the values on the diagonal must be 1, and it has to be symmetric positive semi-definite. Recall that a real matrix M is positive semi-definite if for any vector x, the number you get by taking x transpose times m times x is greater than or equal to 0. This doesn't help us immediately, but symmetric positive semi-definite matrices have a number of useful properties. For example, it can be shown that all eigenvalues of such matrices must be greater than or equal to 0, and this is what we'll use to arrive at upper and lower bounds for rho. Let's try to find the eigenvalues of the correlation matrix C. We'll first decompose the matrix C into a diagonal matrix consisting of 1 minus rho and a matrix with every entry equal to rho. The first matrix is just 1 minus rho times the identity matrix, and we can factor out rho from the second matrix to get rho times a matrix with every entry equal to 1. Let's call this matrix A. To find the eigenvalues of C, we'll first find the eigenvalues of this A matrix. For any vector V, multiplying on the left by A will yield a vector whose entries are just the sum of all the entries in V. Let's think about when this vector is equal to some constant lambda times V. If we do a little thinking, it becomes clear that the only values of lambda that satisfy this expression are lambda is equal to n, in which case V must be a vector with all entries equal to 1, or lambda is equal to 0, in which case V can be any vector whose entries sum to 0. So, the two eigenvalues of A we want to consider are lambda equal to n and lambda equal to 0. Now, if lambda and V are an eigenvalue and corresponding eigenvector of A, then by the definition of eigenvalues, A times V must equal lambda times V. We can use this fact to help find the eigenvalues of C. Let's multiply this vector V on the left by C, giving us 1 minus rho times the identity matrix plus rho times A, all multiplied by V. Distributing the V inside the brackets, we can see that we're multiplying A and V on the right-hand side, which is equivalent to lambda times V. Factoring out the V again gives us 1 minus rho plus rho times lambda multiplied by V. So, 1 minus rho plus rho times lambda and V are eigenvalue and eigenvector pairs for C. Plugging in n and 0 for lambda, we get two eigenvalues for C, specifically 1 plus n minus 1 times rho and 1 minus rho. Now, remember that since we want C to be positive semi-definite, both these eigenvalues have to be greater than or equal to 0. Rearranging these expressions gives us that rho is greater than or equal to negative 1 over n minus 1 and less than or equal to 1. And so with that, we found our upper and lower bounds for rho. I hope you've enjoyed solving this problem and maybe you learned something new. If you like solving math questions or want to prepare for a technical interview, please consider subscribing to the Quant Quest. I'll see you next time.